Late last week, a federal judge here in the state of Florida, a judge by the name of Donald Middlebrooks, issued a ruling that Donald Trump and his lawyers had to pay close to $1 million to a group of defendants of a lawsuit that Middlebrooks had actually thrown out last September. Those defendants include people like Hillary Clinton, the Democratic National Committee, Lisa Page, Peter Strzok, and a whole host of other Democratic staffers who Trump had unsuccessfully sued, arguing that their talking points about his connections to Russia or Russia trying to help him in 2016 were in fact somehow defamation. So, as I said, the judge dismissed that case back in September, but he wasn't done with them. No. Judge Middlebrooks decided, y'all gonna have to pay. What you've done here, and this is what he said in the ruling this past week, you've clogged up the court system. You filed this frivolous lawsuit. He said, quote, this case should never have been brought. Its inadequacy as a legal claim was evident from the start. No reasonable lawyer would have filed it. It was intended for a political purpose. None of the counts of the amended complaint stated a cognizable legal claim. He then said that all of the parties were needlessly harmed in order to dishonestly advance a political narrative, and that Donald Trump had a pattern of misuse of the courts. So as I said, nearly $1 million in legal fees that Donald Trump and his lawyers now have to pay to people. But the big one, the one that sticks out, the one that's going to hurt Trump the most just right here, is the $171,631 that he has to hand over to Hillary Clinton herself. So Donald J. Trump, the man who defeated Hillary Clinton in the 2016 election, thanks to the Electoral College, even though she got millions more votes, now has to write her a check for $171,631. Now, I know that's no compensation for Hillary for losing to the guy, but I gotta imagine there's part of her that's gonna absolutely love that. Now, I am curious to know whether or not Trump is going to have to personally write out the check himself, or if, you know, they're just going to have to wire or transfer the money, whatever it is. But it's going to be humiliating for him. This is the individual that he appears to hate more than anybody else on the planet. Like, I just hate Hillary Clinton so much, is the way Donald Trump is. And now you have to give the person you hate the most the thing you love the most, which is your money. And it all happened because you filed this lawsuit that you should never have filed to begin with, that had no chance of winning from the start. So you look like an idiot back when it got dismissed. You look like an idiot when you got sanctioned. Now you're going to look like an idiot again when you have to hand her that check. And I think Hillary Clinton and her lawyers should have gone and argued that Trump should have to hand deliver the check himself. Like, that is absolutely something the courts could have done. That would have been awesome. And I would have loved for Hillary Clinton to film the whole thing, right? The judge should have said that. Like, go ahead and pour a little salt on that wound because Trump absolutely deserves it. But I can also tell you that this decision by the judge to, you know, smack down Trump and all of his lawyers, of which, by the way, 16 of Donald Trump's lawyers have now been sanctioned by courts. Not just with this one, but other cases as well. 16. That's really, really bad. And Alina Haba, who was sanctioned with this case, is also likely to be sanctioned in New York. That's what Judge Arthur Engoron has suggested he might do. And after seeing what happened in Florida, he might be more inclined to do so. But the day after this decision was handed down, Donald Trump decided to drop his $250 million lawsuit against New York Attorney General Letitia James that for some reason he filed in Florida. And hey, lucky enough for him, it also ended up in front of Judge Donald Middlebrooks. So he decided, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and get rid of this lawsuit. We don't want to pay more sanctions. I don't want to have to write Letitia James a check. So I'm going to be done with all that. So hey, there's a silver lining. Maybe we don't have to put up with any more of Donald Trump's frivolous and fictitious lawsuits for a while. But in the meantime, Hillary, keep checking that mailbox, because you can expect a $171,000 check from Donald Trump to be showing up any minute now.
Ring of Fire has fresh content 7 days a week, so if you want to be reminded about it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell to be notified every time a new video goes up.